Well, good afternoon, everybody. Today we're going to take a look at a communication app called GoTalk Now. If you're familiar at all with GoTalk, GoTalk Now is basically taking the old GoTalks and moving them onto the iPad, allowing you to have a little bit more of a dynamic tool for communication. The GoTalk system by the Attainment Company was a hardware system that, or it still is a hardware system that has the capability to record, I believe, up to 25 messages on it, and then have it played back when a user pushes the button. So they can use that for communication. GoTalk Now basically takes that idea and concept and puts it onto the iPad and gives us a little bit more functionality with it, and that's what we're going to show you with that today. There is two versions of this app. There's a free version, which is what we're going to look at. The version that you would purchase retails for $79.99. So in terms of communication tools, that actually is fairly inexpensive. Most of the other communication tools are quite a bit more expensive than that. What GoTalk Now does, if we open it up, this is what, I'm going to take you back to the home screen. Hopefully we'll get back to that home screen fairly quickly here. You're seeing the player, or you're seeing the page editor there. What this allows us to do, I guess we can dive right into the editor, is, there we go, we're in the editor. We can create these communication boards that students can then use to communicate for different things. So the way that you want to start is if you look down at the very bottom of this, next to that home button, there's three little slider bars. This is in edit mode. We hit those three little slider bars. It's going to show us how we can set this up. It shows us a background option. We can change the background color if we want. I'm not going to do that. I'm going to leave it as is. But then it shows us the number of buttons we can do as well. So we can have one button, four buttons, 9, 16, or 25. Right now I have it set to 4 on this particular board. If I were to hit, say, 9, it's going to change our board and convert it to show us 9 buttons. And it's still kind of working on it on my screen, probably still working on updating it on your screen, but you'll see in just a second that all it'll do is change it to having 9 buttons on there. So if we change to 16, it'll show us 16. 25 shows us 25. I'm going to take it back to the 4 that we had originally here. You're also going to see on this we have scanning auditory cues. So if we set this up for scanning, we can have it set to give auditory cues to the scanner. We can, if we don't have it enabled, we can't use the board in player mode. So right now, again, we're in edit mode. We can edit within this. In player mode, we play these things back out loud. The express page, that's a second component here. Right now, what this page is considered is a standard page. So once we're done making this, when we press the button, when we go to use it, we press the button, it's going to play whatever's associated with that button. If I turn on express page, what you'll see is you're going to see it convert, and there's going to be a little white box up at the top of the screen. If we're using it in express mode now, when I start tapping the buttons, it's going to build something up in that white box across the top, and it's not going to speak it until we tap in the white box. So it's going to allow us to build something up before going through and speaking. So you would kind of choose whether you want to, here the biggest key is choosing the number of buttons and whether or not you want that express page. I'm going to turn that express page off for a second here. And I'm going to go in, and what I want to show you is how we can create some of these buttons. So I've got breakfast, lunch, and dinner on there right now. The next thing I want to add is I want to add a page for what somebody might do if they want to have a snack. So to change, because we're in edit mode, I'm just going to tap on that blank white box, and it's going to show me kind of the inner workings of the button itself. So what I want to do first is I'm going to go and add a button image here. I'm going to add some snacks to this. So I'm going to hit Add Image. What Add Image is going to do is it's going to give us several options. We can pull an image from the GoTalk library, an internet search. We can take a photo, or we can use something from our photo library. I'm going to go and just use the GoTalk image library. You'll see a library pop up, and I'm going to start typing in snack and see what we get. And we get some options here like peanuts, popcorn, pretzels. I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to tap on the popcorn, and we'll add that to our snack page. Now, what's neat about this is once it's here, we can move this around, we can shrink it, resize it, rotate it, whatever we need to do. I'm going to shrink it a little, and to shrink it a little, it's just like zooming in on something. You tap on that picture and pinch your fingers together, and it's going to shrink that picture. If I wanted to rotate it, I'd just turn my fingers while I have it on there. And you can see there I rotated it. And I'll take it back. Now the other neat thing about GoTalk Now is that we're not locked into having just one image per cell. I can take this popcorn, I can slide it over, and I can go back into add image, and I can go to the GoTalk library again, and this time I can type in maybe fruit, and I can choose an apple as well. We'll choose an apple, and we'll move that over to the side. Now I can add image, I can add text to this button as well, where it says button text down at the bottom, I'm going to tap button text, and where it says text, I'm going to tap on that, and now I'm going to type in snack. So once that's all set, and I've typed in snack, I'm going to hit done. And I'm going to leave the font as is. I can change the size if I want. I can change the font, change the color. I'm going to leave all that right now. And when I hit button text, I should see the word snack appear within my button as well. Now with this too, I can move that word all over the place once it's written. I can move that around and set it where I want it to set. So I can offset pictures if I want. There's a lot that I can do. I can change the background color and the border through those two buttons over on the far bottom left, but I'm not going to walk you through that. That's pretty self-explanatory. If we look up at the top, there's two buttons up there. There's action recorded and auditory cue recorded. We're going to start with the auditory cue. Basically what this lets us do is it lets us record potentially two messages on each button. With the auditory cue, we can use that for multiple things. We can use that for auditory scanning, so that when it goes through and scans, it plays back our auditory cue to tell us what this button does. We could use it for somebody with a visual impairment to kind of tell them what's part of that button. Or we could use it as the beginning of of a conversation. So we could record one message into that and then another message into the action and have two messages per button. And that's what I'm going to do here. So I'm going to tap on the auditory cue. And it looks like I lost my air server. Oh, no, there it is. It came back. Tap on that auditory cue. And so what it allows me to do here is I can either record audio or type something and have it do a text-to-speech or do nothing. If I want to do the text-to-speech, I have to pay an extra dollar to get the text-to-speech component in here. I'm not going to do that right now. I'm just going to record audio. So I'll hit Start Recording. I'm hungry. I would like a snack. I'm going to stop recording. Apparently while I'm recording, air server shuts down. But all I'm doing is hitting record, so it should be okay. Now I could listen to my recording. And let's try this again. Listen to it one more time. And doesn't want to play back. It might maybe having some issues with audio and air server, but it is in there. It's recording. It should be good to go. The next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to go to the action button, and I'm going to tap that. And now within the action button, what you'll see is I can do lots of different things. I can record audio. I can use text-to-speech. I could jump to another page, or I could add a video to be played, or have audio played as well. Since I'm hungry and I would like a snack in here already, I'm going to hit jump to page, and I'm going to have this change to a different page. And you're going to see when I hit change, it's going to pop up all of my pages there. I'm going to choose the snack page and have that sent to the snack page. And so now I have done what I want to do to this button. I can hit done, and it saves it, and now it's part of my little communication board here. So I have breakfast, lunch, snack and dinner on this communication page. I'm going to try and play one of these and hope the audio is working. Let me make sure my audio is cranked up on the computer, just in case it's trying to play through the computer on me, which I don't know that it is, but let me make sure that that's cranked up as much as we can as well. The Air Server went through some recent updates, and so we're working through some other issues right now with playing audio on here. So now what happens with when we have this, I guess the other thing we want to take a look at is if we look down in the bottom right corner, there's an exclamation point and a thought bubble. If I tap on that, what that's going to bring up is core vocabulary. And so we can have four things that are always in there. And right now I have a greeting, and then I have a picture of myself where I would use to introduce myself. So that's going to show you that we can bring in pictures that we have on our iPad. It doesn't have to be all symbols, but we can bring in pictures. And you can see it says there, tap to add a button. If we tap on that, it brings us up to that button page just like we had before. So now, I'm going to take you out of this and I'm going to show you how to use it. So to use it, to go to the play mode, to get out of this, we got to either hit the home button, and that'll take us to the main page, or we take three fingers and slide down. So I was in page editor before. Now I'm going to go ahead and hit player. And when I hit player, it's going to bring up that board again. Now, if I hit breakfast, of course it's not speaking, but and I'm not sure why it's not speaking right now. Everything should be turned on. It must be an Air Server issue. But you saw it pop up and be outlined in orange. If it's outlined in orange, that means it's indicating it's saying the first phrase that was attached to this. What I had said in there was, I'm hungry. It was the first thing. Now, if I hit it a second time, it should go green this time. I guess I only have one thing recorded in there. Maybe it was dinner where I had two things recorded. Yes, if it's green, it's doing the first thing. I apologize. Green plays the first cue, orange plays the second cue. So when I hit dinner, when I hit dinner, it said, I'm hungry. And if I hit it a second time, it's going to turn orange. It's playing the second message. This time it's saying, what are we having for dinner? Now, if I hit the snack button, it did the first time what the snack button did, or it'll say, I'm hungry, I want a snack. If I hit it a second time, it's not going to say anything. It's going to jump us to a snack page. And so what that does is it shows us another cool thing that we can do here. Within GoTalk Now, it doesn't have to just be those box buttons that we use. There's another option for tools here that we can use, and that's we can take a picture of an object and draw boxes around different parts of that picture and give it an opportunity, give us an opportunity to add communication pieces to that. So at this point now, if I were to hit the milk, if I were to touch the milk, it's not doing it, but it's speaking out loud, I would like some milk. If I hit the yogurt, I would like some vanilla yogurt is what it's saying. So we're giving all of this in a picture, a scene per se, without having to do these boxed up buttons. I want to show you how we can kind of create one of those. If we go back, let's go back to the home button here. And I'll take my three fingers and slide out of this. Or the other thing we can do is hold down the home button for 8 seconds. So we'll hold that down for 8 seconds and hope it changes for us. There we go. Gets us back to page editor. So I'm going to go back into page editor. And I'm going to go ahead, and one of the options we could have chosen here was a scene display. And so I'm going to go to that scene to show you what this is going to look like. So this is what the scene kind of looks like when we've got it going. We've got our picture. We've got all these boxes around what we want to activate. If I want to add another box, if you look at the bottom of that milk, there's a little add button. So I can hit add, and it's going to give me a box. And I'm going to drag that box over the cheese and crackers. So drag that box over the cheese and crackers. And now you can see that it's kind of into other pieces there. It's over the grapes a little, over the chocolate milk a little. So I'm going to grab one of those buttons in the corner, and I'm going to shrink that box. And then we'll do it again from the top corner. And just shrink. Oops. That it's having some trouble with the milk. So we'll move it down. We'll shrink it a little and put it back over the cheese and crackers. Now I've got to do something with this box because I've put a box over that, but it has nothing attached to it. So if I tap on that box, it's going to give me a few options. It's going to give me the option to delete it, the option to set an action to it where we could jump to another page, or the option to set an auditory cue. I'll set an auditory cue. Just tap on that, and it's asking me again to I'll record audio, so you're not going to see this and likely not hear it either, but we'll hit start recording. I would like some cheese and crackers. Stop recording. As it comes back, that's what I've recorded in there. We'll play it, but I'm guessing you're not going to hear anything. That's more of a manner of trying to display this through the computer than anything else. It does work. Trust me, I was just messing with it this morning. So it does play back out loud. And now we've got that included into our scene with the cheese and crackers component there. So if I hit back and hit the home button, I can go into player. And now we'll see, I'm starting from my main page. I can link as many pages as I want together if I buy this. The professional version of this. If I buy the full version, I can link as many pages as I want. I've got my breakfast, lunch, dinner, snack there. Down in the bottom corner, I've got my bottom right, I've got that exclamation point with a thought bubble. So if I pop that up, it's going to have my core vocabulary in there that I wanted. I can use those to say with where I have myself. If I tap that once, it says, "Hi, my name is Jim." If I tap it a second time, it says, "What is your name?" And you can see that it has two messages in there indicated by the changing colors. I also have a button of a guy jumping. So if I see that and I hit that, it's going to show me all the boards I have access to. I can jump directly to, say, the snack page. And it should take me there. And we can bounce back and forth. You see the jump and the exclamation point are always there. We can always do those. The home button's always there as well. We can go back and forth between, we can hit the back button to go to the previous one. Lots of different things we can do with this. Downside of this is that it does take a little bit of building by the teacher, by the individual, to be able to use it well. But we have unlimited access to pictures. We can pull pictures from the internet. We can pull pictures from the symbol library. We can take our own pictures. If you do buy the $80 version, there is a store where you can download pre-made boards from it. I'm not sure if they cost anything or not. Likely they do, but you can download boards from there. You can access different symbol systems as well. If you don't like the symbol library that they have here, you can access other symbols within the purchased version. With the free version that we have here, you can create up to 5 boards and use it. So I would definitely recommend downloading the free version and trying it with a student that might struggle with communication, seeing how they like it, and kind of going from there before diving in and purchasing any of the other versions. So what my goal was today was to just show you some of the what a board looks like, what a scene looks like, and show you kind of the ease of creating one of these options and how you would go about adding voice, adding images, being able to add multiple images there. I think this is a really nice communication tool. I think it really gives you the capability to be creative and do whatever you want with it. And it has a lot of freedom for doing lots of different things. And I think that can really be helpful to getting a student to use this. So I would definitely recommend checking out GoTalk Now. Does anybody have any questions about GoTalk Now? I'll give you a second if you have a question to type it into the chat box, and Jenny will make sure to get that question on to me. If there are no questions, we appreciate you sitting in on this session this week. I apologize for the audio not coming through from the app itself, but hopefully you were able to get the idea of how it works without actually hearing it. It was just playing back my voice, so it was not any robotic voice you have to listen to. It was playing back my voice that was recorded into it. But again, a very good app. If you have questions on it outside of the webinar, feel free to email me at james-stachowiak@uiowa.edu. Thanks, and have a great day, everybody.